your bitches. I mean, wonderful people. Just had dinner. Had a meal about it. First part of the ritual, filling my branch of beef. And I was looking down this guy and I was getting all this violence, so I was thinking, yeah, that's what that's going to be then. This video was going to be the super duper mesh style lit video. Watching Peter Rabbit. I just got a crash off of the caffeine that I had earlier. Big crash. So what's going on with me right now? That's usually my videos, what I make is what's going on with me right now. And right now it is loving on people. Being positive. Having self-love and allowing that self-love to spill over into loving other people. And being positive. This thing was wonky. They invited me to listen to them argue and I was like, nah. Male. Yeah, I realised that a more positive approach is that everybody is different and that each person is an individual person. I like to believe that everybody is different and that the qualities of a person depend on their character and not on what sex they are. onto a bloke today. I said, I do. He was tall. Boy, he was tall. I don't know why. Yeah, it's programming. I was working in the general office of the town hall there, and they were saying, oh, he's tall, you know, and I was thinking, oh, so I guess I got to think that, like, so if someone is tall, then that's better, you know. Whereas, if you saw the Nigel Benn fight, where a nurse is really tall guy, he clobbered him. But then again, everybody's an individual and everybody, you know, et cetera, et cetera. It's a bit, you know. Tyson. He's going to let me knock him out. You know. Just keeps going for the uppercut. Keeps it close. You know, lets him come right in and has him all over him and then, you know. Reminds me of that bit in Coming to America where they're talking about the boxing. What, arguing over boxing and talking shit as well. I film had a lot of Eddie Murphy's in it. I may take a bus for Rome. And honouring of the power of methods of relaxation in terms of, with regard to anxiety, like all the good stuff, you know, meditation, relaxation, positive thinking, you know, all that. Am I story spiritually where I am at the moment and what I've learned and how I use that to kind of save me out of keep myself positive, you know, etc. I didn't wanna, but no, the right way to say it is I was reluctant, which means I was resistant to, I don't know what I'm saying now, long words, man, mash your mind up. Burning, he's nicking the vegetables. There's a tomato in his trap. Where my mind is at right now is that something about the shame of not seeing that first time around. Be vulnerable. how to be offensive while saying very bad on God. Or not, indeed. Yeah, I was on about like meditation and stuff. Just hold space for what I'm saying for a sec. And the anxiety, the suffering. I thought that I'd opted out of suffering. You know. Releasing the releasing by way of feeling fully feelings of isolation. I felt that I'd been kicked off the planet, kicked out of existence. And I had to call an ambulance. I guess my soul wanted to get it over with as quickly as possible. Yeah. But I don't really want to delve into that too much. Just leave it in the past where it belongs. It's not part of my story of right now. It's kind of a story of quite recently sort of thing. I went for a walk, I thought that I needed to pull. I thought that, I mean, yeah, I did, kind of think that through logically. Which was another release. I did actually give someone my phone number. Just threw it in the bin. Good for conversation, you know. I'm really at what I enjoy, you know. Good conversation would be dope. Yeah, growing through pain. I'm gonna let that one go. There's no need for it. There's no need for it. I mean, Teal Swan used the word momentum. When I've been living a certain way for so long, it absolutely does carry on. It has to like slow down. It can't just stop because you go flying off the planet, you know. So learning through pain is something that needs to wind down. and that will come about through my practice of positivity. I'm wondering how well this video will do. That's all. Meditation style, where a thought comes and then it goes. I still haven't meditated during the video. I mean, like, I'll meditate when I'm out and about, you know. I meditated when, I can't remember which way I was going actually. Was I going to my mum's on the train and bus, or was I on my way back? I'm not sure. Could have been both. Don't remember. Yeah. Naturally, the first thing I did when I started on self-love was to... I became empowered immediately, and I felt that that was the point where I needed to put up boundaries, and then I started going through negative thought loops around other people's behaviour towards me, like it wasn't fair. You know, which I quickly realised that that was a downward spiral. And my solution to that was to love on other people. You know. I mean, it's similar to when I learned about... this is from Elise. She said, going back quite a while, was saying that to not trash talk myself in my head or out loud, you know. And I realised straight away that, and that applied to other people as well. Same sort of thing. What's that then? Yeah. Thinking about crack cocaine and how I have a beer to because it's better to have a beer. For me. I am trying to not be doing it anymore. I didn't get very far with this. I did Santa, which I've lost him. I don't know where he is. I did Rudolph. Could put the antlers on though. He's over here. There he is. What else? Christmas tree. There we are. It's not bad, is it? Yeah. I put a couple of stickers. I've got him on the house, and I'll be in the middle of the snow there. But these are the stickers that go on that. I took I was quite fond of the raccoon. That's why I stuck him on the house. Just stuck him in the house. Scaring everybody out of the house. That feels like me, you know. It's so dope that everybody else just leaves, you know. Yeah. I learned yesterday and today. Yesterday was where I learned self-love, and today was where I learned to not take that self-love and use it to dehumanise other people. I started to believe that I was in danger. I mean, when I broke my leg, I saw how mortal I am, you know, and how I can't let other people take advantage of me. So I caused that. So, yeah. And secrets are strangers. Yeah. When I came back and singing a couple of songs, See You Alive and Toad Low, Choose After. My neighbour was mocking me for saying hi to him. Or praising me, I'm not sure. I mean, it's kind of a fear or love and sarcasm where it can either mean what it's supposed to mean or in defence, you know, or if the person doesn't take it well, then to be sarcastic, you know. But instead it's like fear or love, you know, it can be taken either way. You know. These remind me of them. See these things here? They remind me of a Zoolander where he says, I could put a shit in a piece of tin foil and hang it on my ear and everybody would be like, yeah. Says have a beer. Have a beer. I wonder what would happen if crack cocaine was illegal. I mean, it seems to be the way things are going, to be honest. I mean, legalising marijuana in America. Some people can handle it, some people can't. It's funny that they have guns, you know, and they're worried about what drugs do. Yeah, I realise that I'm free. I'm free. In the theory of like everybody is the same person, I can get closer to someone special by simply gradually accepting other people more, listening to what they say, not allowing it into my being, you know, their words. I mean, to start with, my story has been that it's something that overloads my mind, you know, in the past and in the present, is something of great joy to me. And I like to get close to people through understanding them, through them being themselves around me and accepting them for who they are. Yeah. And finding someone special by getting closer, person by person, you know. And if everybody's the same person, then I've got closer to that special person just by being closer to strangers. You know. I remember when I used to just chat with people. This was in the summer when everybody was happy. I mean, I can't blame them. You know. I guess, I don't know, yeah, I was chatting with people and getting quite close to people, and then the winter came and I seemed to have, well, in my reality anyway, in my perception, anyway, the positive way of looking at it is that, you know, what I just explained, which is a continuing, which is like the second half of, I kind of put those two stories the wrong way around. I put the last bit first and the first bit last, chronologically. I'm going to end this video. It's been great. I've really enjoyed it and I hope you've enjoyed it too. Okay, bye-bye.